Rolling a die, drawing a card out of a deck, and flipping a coin are all things we're familiar with, and these are often used to discuss the basic concepts of probability. There are four key terms that are often used with probability. A probability experiment, which is a process where specific results are obtained, such as rolling a die, as there are only six possible outcomes. An outcome is another key term, which is a single result of a probability experiment. So if you draw a four of hearts from a full deck of cards, that is an outcome. Sample space is another key term, and it is a set of all possible outcomes for a probability experiment. For instance, the sample space for rolling two dice is here, and you can see the possible outcomes for die one and the possible outcomes for die number two, and the sample space is the pairs of numbers listed on the chart here. So there are 36 possible outcomes in this sample space. Event is another key term used in probability, and an event is a set of outcomes of a probability experiment. It is a subset of the sample space, and an event with one outcome is a simple event, and a compound event consists of two or more outcomes. For instance, the event of rolling a 4 on a die roll is a simple event, and the event of getting an even number on a die roll is a compound event. There are three main types of probability: classical probability, empirical probability, and subjective probability. Classical probability is used when each outcome in a sample space is equally likely to occur. For instance, the sample space for rolling two dice, and each of these outcomes has the same chance to occur. The formula for this is P of E. Probability of any event equals the number of outcomes in event E divided by the total number of outcomes in the sample space. So the probability of the two dice totaling 5 is P of 5 equals 4, the number of possible combinations that total up to 5, divided by 36. The total number of outcomes in the sample space. Empirical probability is when each outcome is not equally likely to occur, and it is based on observations obtained from experiments. For instance, let's say you polled 50 people and asked them what their favorite sport is. Using a frequency table, 29 said football, 11 said basketball, 6 said baseball, 3 said soccer, and 1 said tennis. Now we can compute probabilities for each of the categories. The formula for empirical probability is the probability of event equals frequency for the class or the event divided by the total of the frequencies. So the probability of football being a person's favorite sport is 29 divided by 50, which is 0.58. And the probability of tennis being someone's favorite sport is 1 divided by 50, which is 0.02. And you can convert these to percentages by multiplying by 100 to get 58% and 2%. Subjective probability is based on an educated guess or an estimate. For instance, if I were to say there was a 73% chance the Yankees win the World Series next year, this is based on my experience and evaluation. And there are four key rules to probability. The first is that probability of an event is between 0 and 1, including 0 and 1. And this is written as 0 less than or equal to the probability of an event less than or equal to 1. And whatever the value of p is can be written as a fraction or decimal. For instance, the probability of getting ahead on a coin toss is 0.5, or 1 over 2. Rule number 2 is that the sum of all possible outcomes in a sample space is 1. So the sample space for a die roll is 1 through 6, with each having a 1 over 6 probability of occurring. Add these up, and we get 1. Rule number 3 is if it is impossible for a given event to occur, so it's not part of the sample space, its probability is 0. For instance, the probability of rolling 8 on a die roll is not part of the sample space, so its probability is 0. Rule number 4 is that if an event is certain to occur, its probability is 1. So the probability of rolling a 1 through a 6 on a die roll is certain to happen, so its probability is 1. Alright my friends, hopefully this video helped you out. I do have more videos right there for you. Till next time, I am out of here.